Hello, I'm Larry Bowles. I teach, perform, and compose in the St. Louis area, and this is a mini course in right hand technique, and I also have a piece for you called Prelude and Allegro. You need to sit with either a footstool or some device that elevates the guitar so that the guitar is on your left leg, and the head of the guitar or face is at your ear or eye level. You need to balance the weight of your head on your spine. Your head has weight like a bowling ball, and if you're relaxed and you lean to the left, you should kind of follow the left. You should be that relaxed. You should feel the weight of your head on your spine and balance it. Very important to do that. You can sit for many hours if you balance your head on your spine instead of hunching over like a lot of guitarists. They're always looking at what they're doing, hunched over. Your back will become hunched over a period of years. You won't be as comfortable and you won't be able to play as well. The guitar needs to be high on your chest. I've got it about where the sternum bone is. Some of these things can be adjusted, of course, for your body type. I'm using a neck up, which I like very much. It's very, very comfortable, a lot more comfortable and better for your body than a footstool. I can actually sit on this couch and be able to be in a good position, or I can sit in a chair. But I'm always supporting my own weight by balancing the weight of my head and my spine. Now, we're going to talk about right hand technique today. I taught myself for about 2 years, having played other instruments, and got into big trouble with technique like a lot of people that are self-taught. The natural tendency is to put the guitar on the right leg, and the tendency for this hand, for your plucking hand, is to pull the strings because you think you pluck the strings. But what you really should do is you push on the string. But to be able to push on the string, there's a problem because you'll hit more than one string if you don't do it right. I want you to take your first three fingers right hand, put them all on the third string, third from the littlest, put your thumb on the same string, release. Now, there's two schools of thought. You can keep the wrist straight, in which case after you release, you're going to have to let your wrist straighten a little bit. I like that position. Or some people advocate letting the wrist bend a little bit because they think it's more relaxed. I believe Pepe Romero teaches that. Segovia definitely played that way. Both ways have advantages and disadvantages. So you decide, work with a really good teacher. But the main thing is after you're on the third string, with your thumb on the same string, notice that your thumb is away from your fingers. That's very important. Okay, the thumb, if it's blocking the first finger, will inhibit the first finger and you'll tend to use your other fingers more, not use your first finger. So you need clearance between your thumb and the other fingers. Okay? So after you release, I let my wrist go straight. It's up to you. But you never want your wrist to bend in a concave way. If it's going to bend, it has to be towards the ground this way, if you are going to play more straight on to the strings. Now, the bass knuckles are really important. The fastest thing you can do with your right hand is this. Most people claw if they're self-taught. They actually pull like this. They're opposing muscles. It'll give you this kind of tone if you play loud, and you won't get much speed. If you grab your forearm and do a clawing motion, you'll feel this big muscle in your forearm working like mad. It's a crude muscle. It's not quick. Now do this fluttering thing or tapping thing. The tendons are being dragged, so there's a little bit of motion, but the muscle's not doing anything. You're using little muscles located on each side of these knuckles. That's what you want. You want to be able to push through the string and then relax. Push through the string and relax. And there should be movement from the bass. Okay, so let's set up our hand again. The reason why we're doing this is to get the hand low enough to where when you push, you won't hit two strings. Very important. Beginners that are self-taught almost always have the hand too high. They're forced to grab, because that's the only way they can hit just one string. Your nails have to be shaped right. You'll need to get a good teacher for that. There should be no resistance. One reason why many people claw instead of pushing is because their nails are either too long or they're shaped poorly, so they have a lot of resistance. And the only way they can play is to hop over the string to pull. You want to push in towards the next string and towards the back of the guitar to get volume. So you're pushing on the string and pushing through it. Should be relaxed.